all the different facets. And actually, it shows up a lot better on your guys' screen than it does here on mine. All the little black circles are our clients hanging off of our access points. You can see right here in the center, we have a nice open Linksys. Everyone sees those everywhere. That being said, and I can't even read the text, it's so small. That's awesome. But needless to say, there's a ton of clients hanging off of it. Surrounding it, we have our yellow web encrypted clients, also very, very easy targets. And then we get into our green, which is our WPA, WPA2. The black access points that you're seeing there, it means that we don't know what the encryption type of that particular access point is. It may be that the client is sending data and we're too far away from it to actually gather information from the access point. It may be that I drove past it too fast. Any number of things. It just means we're not sure what the encryption type is. To move on to our client probe graphs, and they're still a little hard to see. It's a little bit easier to see on the screen. Our probe requests are outlined in blue. And here we see each client and the request that it is making. In this case, if I wanted to set up a fake access point with something like Karma or Airbase NG, didn't want it to respond on all probe requests, I'd obviously pick Linksys because, well, most of the probe requests are going to it. However, there's a few other ones that might be good. We've got one up here, which I can't quite read what it says. Very, very small. Once again, huge image, very small area. If I remember correctly, this particular image, when fully printed out, would be roughly around 4 to 6 feet by 6 feet. It's huge. Working on scaling the data down, if anyone is familiar with GraphIS, which is what I'm using to generate these images, by all means, talk to me after the talk. I'd love to get your input on this. It's definitely been something that's been plaguing me throughout the project in kind of condensing this down. This is a screenshot from Multigo. This is actually Multigo running on Windows. Here we've imported a data set. We've split it out based on the encryption types of the access points. Special thanks to RBG for generating these nice little icons for me. This is not currently released yet. Well, it is. You can play it. Thanks, Mots. You can play with it in the Backtrack 4 release. The install process is a little convoluted, so we're getting there, we're getting there. But needless to say, it does run on Windows, it does run on Linux. You can go down and split it out into your ESSIDs, which are down here, if you can see my mouse pointer. There are these little purple spiky balls down to our clients. Very, very cool stuff. If you're not familiar with Multigo at all, the data linking you can do in the visualization engine is just fantastic. Go ahead and skip ahead. I guess it's time for a demo of my stuff. So, if you don't mind, I'm going to jump over to a Backtrack 4 beta, which I have Yes, yes, Backtrack 4 beta. Let's get a round of applause for them. They've been working very hard on it.
We worked really, really hard on that.
So much love in this room today. So, anyways, to do a little bit earlier, if anyone saw me frantically out here about, I don't know, half hour, 40 minutes ago, frantically capturing data here at the con, just to get an idea of what it was looking for, I went ahead and did that. And we have, and it looks like I'm going to have to do it manually. Just to show you guys what it looks like, it's your standard Unix-based, all command line driven. So we'll provide our input file. I can see my keyboard here. I must make a note here at this point. Airgraph NG uses the text files. It does not read the PCAP files. It will be very unhappy if you try to feed it PCAP files. So make sure you use the text files. I think I've gotten all the error handling worked out on that, but I still don't recommend trying it. That being said, though, we will continue on, give it a name with our output option. So we'll call this a CAPR graph. All images are generated in a PNG format. If somebody can make an argument for something other than a PNG format, by all means, speak to me afterwards. I'm sure I can work something in for you. It's Python, very, very easy to work with. And then we'll just go ahead and specify our graph type. Notice the fact that all graph types are in capital letters. If you provide it in lowercase, it will not work. It will provide an error message saying, hey, put it in capital letters. Go ahead and generate here. This is a dual core box. It works on things very, very quickly. However, depending on your systems, results may vary. GraphEase does take a little while to generate your images. However, we can now go, and we'll just load it up in Firefox. Generate our image. And here is today's con data. We have our various access points. Looks like there are some people trusting here enough to use the wireless network. I know I'm not. Thank God for cellular modems. We've got the WPA2. It looks like most people are using the open networks. Very, very trusting folks. Either that or they like reinstalling their boxes. So overall, as we scroll down here, we end up with 19 access points, 54 clients shown, and what I feel is a very nice, just general snapshot of what's going on. This was just me standing literally outside that wall for about 5 minutes collecting data, and pretty neat stuff. If we wanted to look at the probe requests, go ahead and do the same thing. We'll just change our image, use the same data set, change our graph type. Those generate a little bit quicker, a little bit less work to do. Fat finger key here. Once again, very interesting stuff here. We've got, I rule you, Preppy, the IBAN conference. Few two-wire probe requests. Definitely see that somebody's been traveling here with their access or their laptop. Best Buy, yeah, okay. Kind of very interesting. We only have one requesting Linksys. Oh, we have one of the free public Wi-Fi zombies wandering around. If anyone's familiar with the backstory on that one, that's kind of a funny story. Josh Wright did a lot of work on that a number of years ago. Quite a few people requesting the ShmooCon. But definitely interesting stuff. Mapping out about 129 clients here and only 29 probes. Okay. Thank you. Not quite done yet, but we're getting there. If we go on to and reference my slides here real quick. Yes, Multigo. This is where stuff gets cool. Very, very cool. Bear with me a second here. The way it currently works is you decide which file you want. In this case, I think I'm going to use a file Mr. X gave me from Chaos Communication Congress. It provides all sorts of very interesting things. You copy your file path, go into Multigo, we create a new graph, and we paste our object. It's going to do it for me. There we go. So this is our basic parse. This is the beginning of all your transforms. You have all your raw data. You decide you want to do something with it. So we're going to go ahead, right-click on it. And just to break it out, we're going to list all the associated access points. At this point, I'm only requesting a very, very few items. I can go ahead and move the slider bar up, ask it to do it again. And voila, we get a lot more data. But needless to say, I'm very, very limited due to a low resolution, so I'll try to keep it simple. If we wanted to, say, view all of our access points, which are unknown, I can go ahead and just select these. And let's see the clients attached to them. So we'll go ahead, right-click, wireless access points to clients. On this set, and it goes ahead and it breaks down and shows that I've got one client per access point, which tends to tell me that, yeah, this is probably where we're seeing the client speak back to the access point, but that's about it. I wanted to say view a grouping of